Today's feature of the week video is the first in a series dedicated to computation methods used in PKanalix. We will start with the integral methods in the NCA task, which compute the area under the concentration curve, so AUC, the area under the first moment curve, so AUMC, and partial areas. In this video, I will explain in detail the options that are available here in the drop-down menu. So let's start from the basics. The area under the concentration profile is a definite integral of a drug concentration curve over time, which is here denoted by C. Definite means that it is calculated between two well-defined time points, here T star and T end. To compute this area numerically, time is divided into small intervals, and the AUC is approximated by a sum of trapezoidal type subareas SI. And these areas are formed by slicing the whole area at each point TI of the grid. A surface of each of these subareas is computed using concentration values at adjacent points. So here it will be TI and TI plus 1. Of course, the more trapezoids we use, the more accurate is the method. In the non-compartmental analysis, we do not have an explicit formula for the continuous concentration curve. So the trapezoidal method is based on subareas created by the consecutive observed concentrations. In PKanalix, a user can select methods which use different shapes of these approximate subareas. In the linear method, we assume that the concentration changes linearly between two observation points. So the slope of each subarea is linear. It gives a trapezoid, which area can be calculated with a standard formula given here. In the logarithmic method, the sloping line does not follow a linear path, but instead it follows the exponential decline with time. The total area is given by the sum of subareas computed with the following formula. So why do we use it? We use it because we assume that the elimination phase is exponential, and so this logarithmic method can approximate it more accurately. However, due to the presence of logarithms, this formula is mathematically undefined if observation values are less than or equal to zero, or if adjacent observation values are equal. And in these cases, the program will use the linear rule. So AUC can be computed using a linear formula everywhere or using combinations of these two formulas, linear and logarithmic. One option that you can select in PKanalix is to use a linear method to approximate the area before the time of Cmax and logarithmic formula after to approximate better the exponential elimination phase. Another option called linear up log down applies the linear formula when the concentration is non-decreasing, so when it goes up or is stable, and the logarithmic formula when it goes down. It is suitable when there are, for example, two absorption peaks and the concentration has two absorption and two elimination phases. The same trapezoidal method with linear and logarithmic approaches is used to compute the area under the first moment curve, which is the concentration multiplied by time versus time. The linear formula is similar to the one for the AUC, with the additional multiplication of concentration by time. The logarithmic formula is more complex and contains now two terms, but the derivation of these two terms is out of the scope of this video. In PKanalix, it is possible to compute also partial AUC. If the time limits that you write here coincide with measurement times of the dataset, then the partial AUC is computed in the same way as AUC using the linear and logarithmic methods. However, calculation of partial AUC can be also requested at time points that are not included in the original dataset, like in these two examples. Then it is necessary to add additional points at these requested times. Imputed concentrations are determined via linear or logarithmic interpolation if the requested point is before the last observed time point, or by extrapolation if it is after the last observed time point. So if the new point is added before the last observed data point, but after the first dose, then the interpolation formula uses adjacent concentration values. So here it uses CI, which is a concentration at time before T star, and CI plus 1, which corresponds to a concentration after the time T star. The linear interpolation formula is a linear combination of concentration values at these two points. The logarithmic interpolation is similar. However, now the formula contains logarithms, so it will fail if one of the measured concentrations is null or negative. In such intervals, the method is switched to the linear interpolation. When the partial AUC concerns times after the last observed data point, then the additional concentration is computed by extrapolation based on the terminal slope of the log transform concentration, that is, lambda z parameter and its intercept. In this case, it is necessary to have lambda z estimated, otherwise the partial AUC will not be computed. So to sum up, in PKanalix, you can select one of the four integral methods. The first three options displayed in the menu in the interface use the same method for calculation of the AUC and for the interpolation. Linear, linear before Cmax, and logarithmic after, or linear for increasing or stable concentration, and logarithmic for decreasing concentration. The last option uses the linear method for the AUC and combination of linear and logarithmic to interpolate points before and after Tmax respectively. Well, thank you for listening and have a good week.